Component 2, Section B, Media Representations and Pharrell Williams's Freedom. This video will look at media representations in Pharrell Williams's Freedom music video. In the video, Pharrell sings and dances to his track in various locations where freedom is stifled, whether it's a sweatshop, a work camp, or locations that show conformity handcuff our freedom of expression and individuality, like a dilapidated shopping mall. The video is also packed with plenty of imagery that evokes the feeling of being free, from horses stampeding on an open range, and two women running naked on a mountainside to birds soaring in the air and countless breathtaking and expansive views. There are certainly diverse representations of ethnicity in this video. For example, ethnic minorities with specific religious beliefs, such as the close-up of a woman in a hijab, reflective of contemporary cultural contexts. This one image in particular is particularly interesting because it represents the woman whom is Muslim in a positive way. Historically, especially after the bombing of the World Trade Center on September 11th, 2001, Muslims have been unfairly stereotyped and demonized in much of the media, especially in America. As an American himself, Williams would certainly have been aware of that. This makes his choice to represent the woman positively all the more impressive because he makes a political statement in doing so, without being over the top in what he's saying. What he is saying is that everyone, especially those demonized for their beliefs, are as deserving of freedom as anybody else. In this particular case, the freedom to practice religion in the manner they choose. The central message of the overall video is about escaping oppression, which means escaping people or systems that act to restrict people's freedoms. This message is made explicit in the video by representations of oppressed minorities, including links to contexts of slavery indicated via long shots of black workers carrying out physical manual labour under the rule of a white aggressor. Images of positive black representations are also used, such as Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali, although now dead, lives on in popular culture not only because he was a gifted boxer, but because he was very political and fought for black civil rights in 1960s America, at a time when black people still did not have the same rights as white people. By including the brief representation of Ali boxing in the music video, Williams is making a passing cultural reference to Ali's historical contribution for the fight for a specific freedom, namely racial equality. Ali is perhaps the most recognisable famous person in Williams's video, and therefore the symbolism of Ali would probably not be lost on most of the audience, especially as a film had been made about him starring Will Smith in 2001. The footage of Ali match cuts to a shot of Williams himself shadowboxing in the same way as the footage of Ali, thereby visually signifying his respect for Ali, respect through imitation. There is a very explicit reference to representations of cultural togetherness in the name of cultural humanity. Ideas about unity between races are presented through examples such as the bird's eye view shot of all races joining hands. The music video also represents places from around the world, in keeping with its central message. The music video begins in Japan, as represented by the busy streets and Japanese writing on billboards, not to mention the Japanese people themselves. Slavery is then represented by the shot of a group of black men standing in rags amongst rock and debris. The men in the shot stare defiantly and proudly into the camera, so Williams's political stance on slavery is clear from the start. As an African American, he would clearly be well educated on the history of slavery, and his choice to represent this idea in this video shouldn't be a surprise given the overall theme of the video. However, the representation in this case is of modern slavery, i.e. the practice of American prisons, forcing prisoners, disproportionately black in America, having to break rocks as punishment. Prisoners have probably not had to do this for a couple of decades, but the image is used to equate the practice with equally backbreaking labour expected of slaves in America before the American Civil War. We know that the prisoners are modern because they are wearing relatively modern clothes, such as shorts and t-shirts. A few shots later in the video, Williams himself respectfully stands amongst the working prisoners. The implication is clear that he relates to them on multiple levels, not just racially but also politically and emotionally. But Williams is far more ambitious in his video than merely representing the historical injustice of slavery, as he wants to represent different cultures around the world, even an Eskimo child. Eskimos are members of an indigenous people inhabiting northern Canada, Alaska, Greenland, and eastern Siberia, and traditionally living by hunting seals and other Arctic animals and birds and by fishing. They have their own alternative society, quite separate from the one that most of us belong to. So in that sense, they have a freedom that most of us don't. Besides the Muslim woman at the beginning, Williams goes on to represent other cultures such as those in India. This is represented by the religious man spreading ashes on the mountain. We soon see a white guard threatening one of the slaves breaking rocks. This is the moment in the video in which Williams explicitly links the oppression of black people with the oppressors being white. This is, of course, entirely accurate historically. There is an interesting juxtaposition of a shot of a flock of birds in the sky with the moment that one of the slaves fights the white guard. The implied meaning is metaphorical in the sense that the slave is fighting for the freedom that should be rightfully his, just as much as the birds in the sky have theirs. We then see Williams stomping before it cuts to a tribesman doing the same somewhere in a desert. Again, the juxtaposition suggests that both Williams and the tribesman are passionate about the same idea, freedom. There is a very specific historical event represented moments later, but curiously it is represented using Lego. The specific historical event is now forever known as the Tiananmen Square Massacre. This very tragic event in 1989, wherein young Chinese protesters were systematically killed by the Chinese government, has since been represented in the media with an image of a man standing in front of a tank. The undeniable power of the image, wherein a man literally stands up for himself in front of a huge army tank, has since entered into pop culture as a symbolic image representing the power of the individual over the forces of the state. Its inclusion here in Williams' music video is quite problematic in terms of how Williams has chosen to represent it. The footage or the image itself is very powerful, so the question is, why did Williams not use that footage? Surely by representing such a tragic event using children's toys callously undermines the tragedy of the event itself. This is a point of contention that could honestly be levelled at Williams. There is no reason other than egotistical artistic pretentiousness for Williams to make such a misstep in terms of representing such a powerful yet tragic, historically important event in such a potentially insulting way. To this day, the number of protesters killed that day is still unknown. So I would argue that Williams, to some extent, undermines his otherwise excellent video through his flippantly irreverent and infantile representation of it. The event was caught live as it happened. Let's take a look. There later follows a shot of Williams standing amongst a rundown shopping mall. It could be implied that Williams is making a criticism of consumerist culture, i.e. the focus put upon the importance of possessions and money in society. He, after all, is saying freedom within this setting. There is also an interesting shot of oppression later on in the video, which acts as a dramatic counterpoint to the representations of freedom in the music video. One such shot is a slow motion shot of a man on a bucking horse. The implication is that the man is oppressing the horse, whom is resisting being controlled by the man. Williams is then seen walking by a line of robotic and expressionless models, and it now seems as if Williams is turning his critical eye on the fashion industry. The visual implication is that none of the models have freedom, because they are told what to wear and how to behave. The later shots of the cheetah chasing antelope in the desert is represented as another example of freedom within the animal kingdom, in much the same way as Williams used birds to represent the same thing earlier in the video. Indeed, all animals represented in the video are represented as free, in juxtaposition to the representations of humans as enslaved throughout the video. This further underlines the point Williams is making in terms of how we humans enforce slavery on ourselves as well as each other as a species. It cuts to Williams again mimicking the physical movements of the antelope, just as he did with Ali earlier, and the sense of flattery through imitation appears to be evident. He relates to the antelope as another oppressed animal whom he feels sorry for and hopes will gain freedom, as indicated in his line, "Run antelope," as he mimics their running posture. There is further dramatic contrast when a shot of the city is juxtaposed with a shot of a waterfall, the implication being that the waterfall represents freedom as it is moving freely, whilst the still foreboding city isn't free. There is a more literal representation of imprisonment later on when William stands on a stage showing a school play with characters trapped in a net. The metaphor is made obvious when the shot is juxtaposed with a shot of a child labourer somewhere in the third world. In other words, innocent children are trapped by the slavery of greed in modern society. It then cuts to a shot of a young black boy, which perhaps suggests that the education system in so-called developed countries is a form of slavery too, in that it demands conformity in order to mould the future workforce in a capitalist society. There is also an interesting representation of age too, where an old woman is seen lifting weights. It is interesting because Williams represents old age against the stereotype found in the media wherein old people are generally represented as weak and feeble. So it can truly be said that Williams has put a lot of thought into a massive range of representations of people, places, events and issues within this video. Williams is later seen standing amongst a sweatshop, a term given for low-paid workers whom do mindless repetitive jobs for little pay. And the implication again is that this is a visual metaphor of Williams standing with, i.e. supporting, these people. Towards the end of the video there are weird and surreal representations of freedom, such as a shot of the mermaid swimming by a man reading underwater. The meaning perhaps is that both the man and the mermaid are free because they are doing exactly what they want, regardless of how odd what they want to do might seem to others. A shot of a woman running through a wall, however, is perhaps the most dramatic visual metaphor in the video, i.e. the metaphor being the breaking through difficult barriers. The last shot of the music video is of Williams pointing to his head while saying freedom. This cleverly refers to the freedom of the mind, the freedom of thought, perhaps the most important freedom of all because, as the famous saying goes, I think, therefore I am. With our thoughts, we make the world. And that's it. Boom.